Goodwill Education Center is the home of the Mavericks. It's the Victor Valley Union High School District's continuation school, if you will, the beneficiary of a new campus, one part of the district's badly needed expansion.
My continuation high school, my independent study high school, my home and hospital, all of the alternative education programs. Now they're a beautiful $50 million facility as well.
Goodwill offers an alternative to the district's two traditional high schools and a new beginning for many, including the Mavericks' elected leader.
It's easier to get more credits here, and like it's easier to catch up, say if you fell behind at drug school in Victor Silverado. You have the opportunity to come here and catch up on like everything you missed. And it's a smaller school, so it's easier to talk to your teachers and, you know, like get some info from your teachers instead of like having like so many kids here where they can never, you know, they don't have time for you.
And it's a small setting. Instead of 3,600 students, we have 575 students. And it's a brand new, beautiful campus, a full campus with gym and multi-purpose room, everything available for the students.
The full-size gymnasium is a key feature of Goodwill. Try to name another continuation school with a gym like this.
Most school districts don't bother with, you know, providing a gymnasium for their alternative education folks. But we felt that we have such a high population and kids that are interested in alternative education, that we wanted to offer them the same type of programs that our high schools have and our middle schools have.
And it's available for public groups and organizational events, but the spacious gym's not all that's extraordinary and out of the ordinary on the Mavericks campus. How about its top administrator? Is he an answer to the Mavericks label?
Oh, am I a Maverick? I think many people in the district would think I am. And the way we do business here, most times, if you look back in the history of continuation schools, it used to be, and I'm not just saying this is correct or not, a dumping ground. Let me tell you, since this school has been here, since I came here just roughly 3 years ago, we have students and we have teachers wanting to come to us. They're calling and saying, hey, do you have openings? I think it's because we do have it open. It's more like a family feel.
On a bigger campus, it's harder for me to concentrate, so I don't even think I would have been, I don't even think I would have wanted to be a leader, because when there's so many people, I get distracted easily. At Victor, I fell into, bad crowd, so I wasn't really, here, it's easier, so.
I think you have to look at Goodwill as more of an alternative setting for students. It's a setting for students that have, for some reason, fallen behind in credits from the other traditional high schools in our district. So they come to Goodwill and it's a credit recovery program. They can earn credits faster. Now, they still have to go core programs. They still have the 230 requirements. They still have one credit per 15 hours, all that. But because of the structure of us, they can earn more credits. We have an 8 grading period instead of a 4 at a regular traditional school. So I think students come here and they go, wow, I can really progress. And for a lot of these kids, because by ed code they have to be 16 years old to come to Goodwill High School, this might be one of the only times academically that they've been successful. So they really enjoy the fact they come here, they get A's, they're earning credits, and they become very successful. In fact, the goal of a continuation school is to get the kids caught up, the students caught up, and then they move back to their traditional site. The issue we're having is a lot of the students don't want to do that because they're afraid that if they go back to that setting, they may fall back with either friends or whatever the reason they lost your credits and lose credits and fall behind again. I believe you have to have an open door policy if you're going to be faithful. Their needs come first, not mine.